Hello everyone, welcome back to my YouTube channel. My name is Liz. In today's video, I'm gonna be talking to you guys about my experience working at Victoria's Secret. So I worked at Victoria's Secret when I was about 18 years old. That was my first job. So I'm gonna be talking to you kind of like on a chronicle basis. So firstly, the interview, there were about 6 girls. So this was a group interview. And like I said, this was my first job. So I was super nervous. I was trying to like hide it during my interview because there were other 6 people like hearing my responses. And the questions being asked were super simple. They were like, why you want to work here? What do you know about the company? What's your availability? And the manager that interviewed us, she said from the start, for us to be hired, we have to have open availability and be able to work on weekends. And for me, this was no problem because this happened to be on summer break after I graduated high school. So I was going to be off for about 3 months until I started college. And the manager said there was no problem with that. And then during the group interview, I remember it was like about probably like 15 to 20 minutes just because it wasn't a lot of questions, but because every girl had to answer, we had to basically wait, and that made it a little longer. The only, I guess, like con during a group interview is that sometimes I was like towards the end of the line, so that she was like going in line in circle, and basically my answer, I didn't want to match it with any other girl that talked before me, so basically I had to come up with different answers that way I don't sound like I'm copying somebody else. So that's the only con during the group interview, but everything, like I said, it was pretty easy, very simple questions like, why do I want to work at Victoria's Secret? And I mentioned to them that like I just love being at Victoria's Secret. I buy, like, even though I don't work there anymore, I buy so much from Victoria's Secret. It's insane. I just love the store, like the aesthetic and all of that. I love it. So I explained all that during my interview. And I remember like about 30 minutes after the interview, I got a call from the manager saying, oh, we would love to hire you. So I was super excited about that, and she like asked me, when can you start? I told her I can start whenever. So I remember going the day like right after the interview, so it was pretty quick. It like did not take long enough, and I went there, and basically I was doing training on the computer or the iPad for like 2 days. So it was a bunch of like training. I think this is like normal with any job, just like computer training before you go up to the floor. I'm not gonna lie, the training was a little boring, like everything on the computer, because obviously I want to be on the floor, I want to be like interacting with customers and all of that. So those 2 days passed, and then I was put on the floor. I remember my first day on the floor, I wasn't doing much. They basically had me working on the panty bar for probably my whole shift. It was like a full 8 hours on the panty bar. And if you guys don't know, or if you guys have not been to Victoria's Secret or Panty Bar, we try to make it super perfect. So we try to have like mediums on the top, and then the drawers are organized like by sizes, extra small, small, medium, large. When I started, I was making about $14.50 an hour. I was super happy at the beginning just because this was my first job, like I said, so making any sort of money was perfect for me. And the dress code we had was wearing black all the time. For me, that this was perfect because me as a person, I love wearing black. If you look at my closet, like most of my clothes are black, so for me this was perfect. I had no problem dressing up in black every day. The only con that I could think of right now was just working that panty bar. Store closed at 9. Sometimes we were there fixing the panty bars until midnight, and like I said, we could not leave until that panty bar is perfectly, like mediums on the top, everything had to be super organized, and then the drawers have to be organized as well, not just like the top and all that. Most of the time the panty wear was messy. There was only like a few days, I think, when I worked like Monday or Tuesdays, that was probably one of those slowest days. The panty wear was kind of not too messed up, but still we had to take at least an hour or two fixing it up. On days like Black Friday, the semi-annual sales, that panty bar, you couldn't even look at it. Like it was a mess, honestly. Like there were panties that you're like asking, why is there a bra on top of the panty bar? Like stuff that didn't even make sense on top of the panty bar. So on holidays like that, like Black Friday, semi-annual sales, sometimes we were there till 1 to 2 a.m. fixing that panty bar and fixing basically all the walls, making sure everything's organized, the clothing is hanged that properly. That was probably one of the cons, just having to stay there for so long fixing up the bar. But like I said, this was my first job, so I didn't mind it too much sometimes, only on weekends, because on weekends obviously I wanted to get out. So on weekdays I didn't mind when I was off school, just because like I said, this was overtime. So this was overtime for me, so I was just making a little more money during the time that I was fixing and being out of the time frame. So sometimes I was working from 2 p.m. because that's where you started for the evening shift, 2 p.m. all the way to midnight. So that's how many hours? 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. So that's 10 hours. So that's pretty good. And imagine like 10 hours times 5, that's 50 hours per week that I'm making. So I'm making a little over 10 hours of overtime, so that was pretty good. Another pro that we had at this job was having 30% discounts on every single item on the store. So I was probably wasting most of my checks at the Victoria's Secret store and on the Pink store as well. So that was probably one of the cons. I was just so in love with the products, and like every day or every week or so, there'll be like new pearl, new panties, new collections. So I just was wasting a lot of my money at Victoria's Secret. So a lot of my money was just basically, I was leaving it there and my check. And I used to work at Cambridge Side Galleria, so this was like a nice mall. So every lunch break, I was like wasting so much money on lunch break just because we had stuff like Sarco Japan. So I was also gaining a lot of weight. And we had Panda Express, we had McDonald's, Burger King. But like I said, I was 18 years old, so I didn't have too many responsibilities. I was still living at my parents, so I was kind of just wasting my checks, not in the most appropriate ways, but that's besides the point. Another pro we had was sometimes we had 50% off select items. So I remember the Victoria's Secret leggings are like about $60 to $80, some of them. And we used to get 50% off, so I used to pay like sometimes $25 to $30 for those leggings. So that's a big discount right there. So I used to love, and I have so many Victoria's Secret leggings that is insane. Who's not gonna take advantage of 50% off leggings? And we also used to get gratises. So sometimes if a new bra was released or like anything, any products that were put on new, or like sprays, perfumes, any sort of new collections, I used to get it for free. So that was a big pro. I used to have so many products from Victoria's Secret, from the gratises, the 50% off. And also when I used to just spend them for 30% off. And one of the biggest things at Victoria's Secret, they push the Victoria's Secret's Angel card, which is their credit card, so much. And I am good at convincing, or at least I was good at convincing people to open that credit card. I had the credit card myself, or I still have it, just because I love, like I said, shopping at Victoria's Secret. And I think I was opening about 8 to 10 credit cards per day. So the manager was super impressed on that. So when she saw that I was like really pushing those credit cards, I started being on the sales representative, but she moved me to the cashier just so I can be pushing those credit cards every single day. And I think one of the days, probably the most credit cards I've opened in an 8-hour shift was 15. And I think this was during Black Friday, just because there were so many customers. And it doesn't sound like a lot, but for a credit card, trust me, this is hard, just because not everyone wants to open a Victoria's Secret Angel card. Not everyone is like that invested into the store to have to open a credit card. So for me to be able to open 15 credit cards, the manager, I remember she was like super impressed. And like I said, I was hired as a sales representative, but when she saw that I was able to open so many credit cards per day, they left me as a cashier for probably like, I was a cashier probably for like 7 to 8 months. This was my first job, so you had to make sales, or at least when I was on the floor, I had to make sales, plus open credit cards. So I was able to convince customers to open their credit cards, especially those people that I saw were buying a lot of products. I'm like, oh, it will be very convenient for you to open a credit card. You'll get so many points from this purchase you're making today. You'll get a discount right now. I think we were offering $20 off their purchase today. And then like I said, I started as a sales representative. They moved me to being cashier for 7 to 8 months. And then finally, when they saw that I was able to make sales plus open credit cards, they hired me as a bra specialist. So I was working most of the time back in the fitting room. So I was sizing customers up, making sure they have the correct size and bras, and I was just pushing bras. So basically, as a bra specialist, you have to be making your sales goals. At the Victoria's Secret I was working for, I wasn't making commission, but you were supposed to make your goals, just because your managers were going off that to see how your work goals are, how you're working and all of that. And like I said at the beginning, I was very shy, so this was my first job. So I was selling here and there at the beginning, probably like my first 2 months, but I wasn't making enough for the sales goals. So one of the days I just thought to myself, I'm like, I need to lose this shyness. I need to just approach customers and be upfront. So I decided to completely change, and I was meeting my sales goals almost every single time. And then the way that people could see it, anybody in the store could go to a computer, you kind of log in and you can see sales goals kind of by 1 through 8. I think we had like 8 girls, something like that, something around there. And basically your name will show up in like which category you are, if you're the first the first seller, the second seller, the third seller. And overall, working at Victoria's Secret, I loved it. There were so many pros. There were, for me, I think there were more pros working at Victoria's Secret than cons. My coworkers were great working at Victoria's Secret. I think everyone was around like 18 to 20, 21 years old. I think even the managers were super young. I think the oldest manager was probably like 25 years old. And the overall experience working at Victoria's Secret was pretty good. Like I said, one of the best incentives was obviously getting discounts, getting gratises. And I forgot to mention, like I said, I started getting paid $14.50 when I started as a sales representative. But once I moved to being a bra specialist, I got a $1 increase in my paycheck. So I was getting paid $15.50. So at 18 years old, I was very excited that I was making at least $15 an hour. So I was very happy about that. And I got promoted, I would say, like in less than a year. So in 8 months, in like 5 to 6 months, I became a cashier. Then after a couple of months, I became a bra specialist. So I was getting promoted pretty like fast, or I would say, because I know some people work at companies and they be there for years before they get promoted. So at Victoria's Secret, if you're good, it's really kind of easy to get promoted and get other opportunities jumped in there. So I like that about working at Victoria's Secret. Probably the biggest con was just fixing that panty bar, like I mentioned before, especially on Black Friday and on big holidays, stuff like that. But overall, working at Victoria's Secret, I loved it. My whole experience was pretty good. And I am super glad that this was my first job. It kind of gave me an overall idea of like just talking to customers, customer service, helping out with my customer service skills and all of that. And for all of you guys who are interested in working at Victoria's Secret or how you even thought about it, I definitely recommend it for you to apply and just give it a try for a couple of months to see if you like it. And that is everything for today's video. Go ahead and like and subscribe, comment down below your questions, and as always, I'll see you guys in the next video. Bye.